Dozens of dogs and puppies are now in jeopardy because Metro Animal Services now has 3 confirmed cases of distemper. Andy Alcock joins us live at Metro Hall with details on the new problem. Andy?
Rick, Metro Animal Services administrators first told us about the first case of this nasty and potentially lethal canine virus on Thursday. Now, over the weekend, 2 more cases have been confirmed, prompting MAS administrators to say 80 uninfected and vaccinated dogs need immediate placement.
It was never really an outbreak per se. We had 3 cases. We quickly got those under control, but the facility's full now.
Mayor Greg Fisher's spokesman Chris Pointer says volunteers and MAS employees have spent this holiday weekend working to make sure the 3 canine distemper cases don't spread. The issue prompted the agency's interim director to send this email Saturday afternoon to Dear Dedicated Rescue Group and Animal Lovers under the subject, MAS Needs Your Help. The email states, in order to minimize potential exposure to the current MAS dog population, we're asking our rescue partners, if able, to pull any dogs or puppies from MAS as soon as possible. Jessica Reed of No Kill Louisville, the same group Mayor Greg Fisher rejected in its bid to run MAS, says she received the email.
It's almost like we want help, but only the kind of help that we define for you.
Reed says it's especially frustrating because on Thursday, when MAS announced the first distemper case, the interim director said it happened because a staffer failed to vaccinate the infected dog. Then after the first email on Saturday, the next day, the interim director sent this email, noting the rescues had placed only 15 of 80 dogs needing to be moved. And if the rest of them aren't moved by the close of business, 6 p.m. tomorrow, the dogs may be euthanized.
So it's placing blame somewhere else.
Reed says she sent an email reply suggesting MAS use its administrative offices as a temporary adoption area to help solve the overcrowding issue due to the quarantined animals. But MAS is sticking to its decision to move the uninfected vaccinated dogs by the end of tomorrow or else.
We do appreciate what the work that No Kill and Humane Society others have done, but we really need the public.
And to help move those dogs as quickly as possible, tomorrow only, MAS will charge the reduced price of $9 to adopt a dog or a puppy. Mayor Greg Fisher's spokesman Chris Pointer also tells us the mayor has narrowed his list for the next MAS director down to 2 people, and an announcement about who that new director will be is likely to come in the next 2 to 3 weeks. Live outside Metro Hall, Andy Alcock, WLKY News.